your damn mouth.
Magnolia.
Something I can do for you, handsome?
Any chance I could steal you away for an evening?
I don't think that would...
Sure. I wouldn't mind hearing a different song.
A good musician listens to her audience. How about this one?
Paying customers only.
Buddy, I need to be a lot more high or a lot more drunk to be bothered right now.
Ever been to kill or be killed? Some fine-looking weapons.
Hey.
God, I love this song.
Like an earthquake, starting to roll, I felt my world shake. Out of control, like a world war starting to brew. Baby, it's just you. Like a cyclone, wild and extreme, I got my mind blown. Stuck in a dream, waking up without a clue. 'Cause baby, it's just you. You leave me breathless, weak in the knees. I'm feeling reckless, pardon me please. The fallout's blowing through, but baby, it's just you.
Trying to stay on good behavior.
The memory den's not accepting new clients right now, sweetheart.
Irma.
Oh, enjoying yourself in Good Neighbor? It's a heck of a town, ain't it? You like the decor? My business partner hates it. Says she's not the fun type.
Hey, Irma.
Where did the memory loungers come from, you ask? Well, a girl's gotta have her secrets.
I'm a bit busy. What is it?
Dr. Amari.
Don't bother asking me how the memory loungers work. I don't have time to teach the years of neurophysiology it would take you to understand.
Not Irma. Good Neighbor's crazy. Thefts, murders, worse. Sometimes you just gotta escape a little to make it through the day. We still talking?
Escape? What do you mean?
Reliving old memories. Like Thanksgiving, 2071. Mom made a 12-pound turkey. And then we all listened to the Silver Shroud versus Captain Cosmos. Even Pa was there. You ever listen to the Silver Shroud? That's what we need. No matter how bleak things got, he saved the day.
My family and I used to listen to every new episode.
You mean when they first aired? How? The last broadcast was hundreds of years ago.
I was in cryogenic storage for a long time. I only just woke up.
Oh man, that's amazing! You're just like Mr. Abominable from episode 83.
Yeah, something like that.
Boy, if you just woke up. The world these days must take some getting used to.
That's an understatement.
Things may look bad, but we gotta try to make it better. I got a question for you. What if the Silver Shroud was real? With his black trench coat and gleaming silver submachine gun? I got a plan to bring him to life. So we can fight bad guys and give the rest of us a symbol of something better.
What plan?
I've built my own custom machine gun. Even better than the one in the show. But to make this work, I still need the most important piece. The genuine Silver Shroud costume herself. And they actually got one here in Boston. They made it for the TV show. Will you help?
I might do it, if you make it worth my while.
I can give you some caps up front. Just promise you'll help me.
I'll get the costume for you.
You're gonna do this? For real? Before the bombs fell, they were filming the Silver Shroud pilot over at Hubris Comics. So that's where you'll find it. You're the best.
You take care, sweetheart.
You're looking to stock up on general
equipment. Can't believe it. They look just like Sammy, too.
Sure as hell didn't, eh?
Because she doesn't fit in anywhere else. She still wants to give men comfort, just not in the way she used to, which is why she now sings on the stage. She comforts people with her music. She says, if you're searching for something to bring you comfort, you're looking for. Most interestingly, she says, have you got a history that needs erasing? An allusion to the memory den, perhaps, to what Dr. Amari does on the side for the murder. And perhaps the song is a message to escape.
I know it's going to hit him too. I was hoping it would. It didn't kill him, but it didn't kill him though.
Possibly a metaphor, or maybe it's literal. Do you sense run on motors? And she says, or are you running
for... Oh, God.
As an escaped synth, you know that you're a synth,
and
that
on top of
makes
me.
You your own worst enemy. You could give away the secret of any time, which could lead the Institute right to you. Maybe you are an enemy.
There's a hole right here. Get up off me.
If the case, and as Magnolia says, you're in the right place. In her song, Baby, It's Just You, we get more allusions to this memory wipe. She says, like an earthquake starting to roll, I felt my world
shift. This is too zoomed in. I'm too zoomed in for the closed room.
I got my mind blown. Stalking your dreams. This may be a song she wrote talking about how she felt after she woke up from the memory wipe. You leave me breathless, weak in the knees. I'm feeling reckless. Pardon me, please. She woke up from having her memory erased. She was breathless. She was weak in the knees, confused, and this made her reckless, which is why she took up chems, which led to her eventual prostitution. Yes. She felt alone. She needed someone to rescue her. She says, help me, help me. Save me, save me. Take me. Because you've got the power. You've got the cure. Like her song, Man Enough, perhaps she feels that the solution to all of her problems, the solution to her confusion, to her recklessness, is a man, is a significant other who can save her from herself. And in her final song, Train Train, this, I think, encapsulates her personal world philosophy, using the nuclear bombs that began and ended the Great War as an allegory. Before the war, it was all a game, the fighting, the militaries, but then the bombs dropped and all of that changed. They heard the boom, boom of the nuclear explosion, and in the gloom, gloom, they went underground. Possibly a reference to the Institute, which is underground, but I think it's more likely that she's referring to the third rail itself, which is underground, because there she stands, having a good time. She says, no need to pay, the pleasure is mine. And here's where her personal world philosophy comes in. Set your mind at ease, you better relax, throw yourself a party wherever you're at, and dance your blues away. You can find your way back to civilization another day. So, who is she? To sum up, an escaped synth who had her mind wiped by Dr. Amari and the railroad in the memory den. But the confusion of the mind wipe made her reckless. She took up chems, got addicted, and resorted to prostitution as a lifestyle until she finally got fed up with it and moved to Good Neighbor to start singing for Whitechapel Charlie. This lifestyle still makes her feel good by bringing...
What the fuck? How I miss? Thank you. I'm about to start swinging them off now. Because there's so many of them. The monkey.
Thank you.